Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial on how to use blends in Illustrator. I'm using some Design Cuts elements in this video, so let's take a quick look at the website and see what I'm using. These are hand-inked tribal pattern brushes. What I'm going to do is just pull out a few elements from the brushes themselves. So what I've done in Illustrator is just open up the Tribal Boho Brushes file, and that gives me access to the elements that have already been created for me. So I'm going to select these fish and I'm going to choose Edit Copy and paste them into a brand new document. Once in that document, I want to expand them so I can get access to just one fish. I'll choose Object, Expand Appearance, and I'll choose Object Ungroup until Ungroup is no longer an option. In other words, until everything is ungrouped. Then with the selection tool, I can select over the fish I don't want and be left with the fish that I do want. I'll quickly check the layers palette just to make sure that there's nothing untoward left behind, and all I've got is one compound path for one fish, so everything's looking neat and tidy. Let's take this fish and pop it over here. I'm going to make a duplicate of it by holding the Alt key option on a Mac and just dragging a duplicate away. I'm going to color it with a sort of darkish blue color. And then I'm going to take another copy, hold Alt or Option, and drag it over to here. And I'm going to make this a lighter color. I've got a sort of blue-gray here that I'm going to use. So I've got my two fish, a dark one and a light one. I'm going to select over the two fish. There are a couple of ways to make blends in Illustrator, and one of them is quite simply to use the blend tool here on the toolbar. I'll click it to select it, and then I'll click on the first fish, and you'll see the mouse pointer has a little asterisk below it that's telling me I'm in possession over the shape, so I'll click once. Then I'm going to the second shape, and this time the mouse pointer has a little plus sign in its bottom right corner, and I'll click again, and that's giving me a transition from one fish to the other. Now, you may not see exactly the same thing as I'm seeing here, but that doesn't matter. The important thing is to know how to fix it. So we're going to double click on the blend tool here and we're going to click on preview so we can see what's happening. This is set by default to smooth color. So we're seeing a smooth color transition from the dark fish to the light fish, but that's a lot of fish and we don't want nearly so many. So I'm going to choose specified steps, and then I'm going to start decreasing the number of steps. And as I decrease the number of steps, I'm going to get less and less fish. So I'm just going to fine tune this to about 17 fish. I'll click OK, and then with the selection tool, I'll just click away from the blend. What Illustrator has done is repeatedly created a number of fish, and each one of these fish is a slightly different color as we transition from a dark fish through to a lighter fish. Now, these are not gradient filled fishes. Each of these fish is filled with a solid color. It's just that they go from dark through to light. That's what the blend tool does. It blends shapes. It also blends colors. By default, each of these blends will have what's called a spine, and in this case, it's just a straight line, and it's a straight line between this fish here and this fish over here. But we can replace the spine with something more interesting. So I'm going to the pencil tool here. Let's just select the color to use with it, and I'm just going to draw out a sort of flowing line. I'll select both the blend here and the line, so I'm going to drag over both of them, and I'll go to Object, Blend, Replace Spine. And now my fish are aligned across this new spine. While they're pointing in the same direction as they always were, they don't actually follow the line very accurately. So let's see if we can change that. I'm going to select over the blend with its replaced spine, and I'll double click on the blend tool. I'll turn preview on, and this time I'm going to use Align to Path. And now the fish are traveling along the path, so I'll click OK. Now let's look at a situation where we're going to make the fish get smaller as well as recolored. So I'm going to select this fish and let's take it with us to a brand new document. I'll paste it into position and let's make a duplicate so we always have a fish that we can use, and I'm going to make this a really dark color. I'll Alt or Option drag a duplicate away, and I'm going to make it again, a lighter blue color, and we're going to shrink the fish, so it's going to be much smaller than it was. I'm holding the shift key as I drag on its corner handle just to make sure that it's sized in proportion. And these two fish are lined up to their middle. I'm just using the smart guide just to make sure they're pretty well lined up. I'll select over both of these fish, and this time let's make our blend a different way. We can choose object, blend, make. It's the same blend process, it's the same blend result, it's just a different way of achieving it. But again, we'll double click here on the blend tool to get our options. I'm going to click preview, I'm going to choose specified steps, I'm going to decrease the steps until I can start seeing the fish. And here, in addition to changing color, the fish are changing size. Each one of these fish is slightly smaller than the last, so it goes from very big here to very small over here. So this time, let's have a look at putting our blend across a different type of spine. I'm going to choose a spiral, and that shares the toolbar position with the line segment tool. I'll click on the spiral tool. I'll click once in the document so we can just see what my settings are. Well, my radius is sort of something around about 400, so I'm just going to make it 400. Decay is 80%. I'm using 10 segments and this particular style. I'll click OK. Now, it doesn't really matter what settings you use. You just need to create some sort of a spiral. So let's select over the fish blend and our spiral, and let's go again to replacing the spine. Object, blend, replace spine. Now we've got a few problems here, and one of them is that the little fish is on the outside and the big fish is on the inside. It would look better if it were the other way around. So I'm going to select over everything. Let's go back to object, blend, and this time let's choose reverse spine. So that reverses the line so that the big fish is on the outside and the little fish is on the inside. But you can see too that the fish is sort of pointing outwards. It's not actually following this spine. So let's see if we can change that. The first thing to try is to double click on the blend tool options, click on preview, and see if this option solves the problem. Well, it sort of does, except our fish is now pointing out from our spiral, and we may want the fish to point in the spiral. But let's just click OK. Let's go to the layers palette and see what we get with a blend. With a blend, we get not just the path, the spine, and that would be a straight line with a regular blend. In this case, it's a spiral because we've replaced the spine. But we also get the two fish at the beginning and end of the path. So let's go to this fish, the bigger one, and let's hold the shift key as I rotate him around 180 degrees. And now our starting fish is pointing in the correct direction along the path. But things go a bit haywire as the further along we go, and the reason is that this fish in the middle is not pointing in the correct direction either. So let's go and select him, and let's rotate him 180 degrees. I'm just holding the shift key down as I do that so that the rotation is exactly 180 degrees. Now we have our fish going along our spiral spine from a big fish to a little fish. Now, if we want more fish, we can do that too. I'm going to select over the entire blend, the blend and the spine. I'll double click the blend tool. I'll turn preview on, and I'm just going to increase the number of steps because every time I do this, I get more fish along my path. These fish are going along the line in the correct direction. We've just got more of them. And of course, each one of them is going to be an in-between color so that the transition goes from this dark fish through to the lightest fish. The final blend we're going to look at is a blend around a circle. And the reason we're looking at this is because it has special problems. Now, I've already got my fish from my previous document. I've just created a brand new document. I'm going to work with a single color fish this time. So it's going to be a blue fish. And I'm going to Alt or Option drag a duplicate away, but we're going to stick with the same color. Now at any point, if you want to make sure that these fish are nicely aligned, just select over both of them, and you'll see here on the tool options bar that you can click on the vertical align center, and that will just align these two fish to each other. I'm going to select over the two fish, and I'm going to create my blend with object, blend, make. I'm just going to get my document centered back again. Now this is a pretty good blend here, but I could double click on the blend tool and I could adjust the number of steps if I wanted more or less fish. So I think I'm about 17 fish in between my ends are just fine. So now let's go and draw our circle. So I've got a circle here. I'm going to hold the shift key to drag it out to constrain the ellipse to a perfect circle. Let's flip the colors so that we just have a stroke and no fill. I'll select over my blend and my shape, and we're going to replace the spine as we did before. Object, blend, replace spine. But here's the specific problem that we have when we try to do a blend around a closed shape. The problem is it only goes 3/4 around the shape. But the solution is quite easy. What we need to do is to cut this shape so it's no longer a closed path, but so that it's an open path. So I'm going to the scissors tool, which shares the toolbar position with the eraser tool. Just going to click on the scissors tool to target it, and I'm going to hover it over this path. And it doesn't really matter for this particular blend where I select my cut. So I'm just going to put a cut here on this anchor point. So I'm just targeting this anchor point, and I'm just going to click once to cut the path at that point. And now you can see my fish are evenly spaced around our path. The problem is, of course, that they're all pointing in the one direction, and we may want them to be pointing in a different direction, possibly following the path. So we'll select everything, double click on the blend options tool, click preview, and try first of all the align to path option. And if that works, you've solved the problem. If it doesn't work, you're going to need to rotate the beginning and end shapes. But in this case, it's solved our problem. But if we wanted our fish pointing out or pointing into the center, let's see how we do that. Let's select over our blend, go to the layers palette. I'm going to open up my blend so that I can locate the position of my starting and ending fish. So here is one of those fish. I'm going to hold the shift key as I rotate it so it's now pointing inwards. Now in this case you'll see that the beginning and end fish are occupying the exact same position. So we need to locate the one underneath and do the exact same thing to it. And now our fish are pointing into the middle. If we wanted them to point out, we would just do exactly the same thing, but rotate them so they're pointing outwards. There's the first one, and here's the second one. You'll see that being able to read what's going on in the layers palette and being able to select individual objects here is a whole lot easier than trying to find them within the blend itself. Now, if the fact that you've got two fish here is concerning to you, and once you're happy with whatever design it is that you have, let's see what you do. You're going to select over all the shapes and you're going to choose Object, Blend, Expand, and that will expand it into its component parts. Let's have a look in the layers palette and see what we've got. Well, now we've got a whole heap of compound paths. Each fish is in its own compound path, and they're all inside a group. So I can go to the group selection tool, and that will help me isolate the fish here. So there's one fish here that's pointing in this direction, and its partner, the double fish if you like, is down here. So all I need to do is to remove one of them, and then we've just got individual fish all the way around the shape. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator techniques. Let us know in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you like this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.